The next thing we're going to do for advanced studio techniques is a thing called snapshot automation. What I've done here is I've selected a section of the song that I want to do something in terms of creating a scene across many different automatable parameters. So I'll just let you hear the track as it stands. Okay, so I want to do it, I want you to take out the drums. I'm going to have the drum reverb just playing kind of in the background for a bit. I'm going to turn that up. I'm going to have a kind of flanger over the vocals. I'm going to mute everything else. So basically what we will be having is something quite interesting just for a bar or so, two bars. So the way that I do this is, first of all, I've made markers up here at the start of that section and another one at this end. I then shift clicked between those markers like this. Shift, hold down with the Alt group enabled. I then performed an edit separate region at selection. And it gave me this section here across all the different parts within the track. Okay, so that's how I managed to get that. So, what I needed to do now was to program some stuff. So what I need to do is to go up to the Windows menu, choose automation, and hold down Alt and click on one of the parameters. It should all then become enabled. I then want to hold down Alt again and choose write, so that all of my tracks go into write mode. I then want to hold down Alt and go to volume so I can see some changes here. I'm then going to go to the vocal part, which is here, and I'm going to add an effect on it. Let's try this one. This is really obvious. Turn that off full. I'm then going to go to automation window, shift click from top to bottom, add them all. That then becomes automatable. I'm going to basically bypass that just now and have it in bypass mode at the moment. I'm going to close that down. And I'm going to close that down. And back to the edit window. So what I'm going to do now is, because there are no breakpoints in here for me to actually write any automation scene changes to, I need to create them first. So I'm going to hit start and then stop using the spacebar pretty quickly, like this. Now that I've done that, I'll hold the Alt key down with the group enabled, all group enabled still, hold down the Alt key and click on the second breakpoint there, which means it will remove them from all. Remember, I'm doing this with the selection made, so that it's done within the confines of the selection that I want. So, I've written automation breakpoints, but I haven't actually done anything now. So what I want to do now is go back to and open up my Windows option again and suspend that automation. And that means I can make changes in here without and hear them. Oops. And I want to pull that back to where it was. It's a bit of an issue there, but not to worry at the moment. So take the old group off, turn up the reverb. Mute drums, these are subgroups, drums and the drum pump track, mute the guitars, bass, saxes, etc. Mute all this stuff. I'm going to come up here and I'm going to take that bypass off. So now that I've done that, I've made my selection here, have this all group on again. What I want to do is basically paste the information that I have set things now to automation and write to all enabled. So by doing that, I made some changes in there. Don't worry too much about the volume change, that was just because I had the all group on at that stage. So what we should notice now, if I then go up to automation, take this off, I can now go back to Alt click on latch and make it read mode. So what I should hear now at this stage is drop the volume, but I should hear the drum should mute, the reverb send should, volume should go up and the plugin should come on. So let's try it. Okay, let's have a look at that on the mix window side. See, that's come on. That's basically it.